shouting. The winning side is the shouting side. Make a joy for now. When you see me shout, I shout like a winner woman.
When you see me shout, I shout like a winner.
Papa,
Begin to declare in the hearing of the Lord that, Lord, I am tired of the valley. This is my month of rising up, oh God. Lord, I am tired of the valley. Lift up your voice and just begin to bless the Lord this morning, because God is bringing you out of the horrible pit. God is bringing you out of that merry clay. Give him all the praise, because his hand is already stretched forth and he's bringing you out of that situation this month. This is our month of rising up, and you and I will arise. Lift up your voice wherever you are this morning and just begin to thank him, because your time in the valley is over. Your time in darkness is over. Your time on the floor is over. Your time of shame, of reproach, of insult is over. Lift up your voice and begin to thank him. Father, I bless you. I give you glory, because this month you are set to raise me up. You are set to raise your people up. Wherever you are joining us from, wherever you are watching this telecast from, God is set to terminate that demotion in your life. God is set to terminate that shame in your life. Lift up your voice and begin to declare in his hearing, Father, thank you, because this month you are bringing me out of the valley. You are bringing me out of the horrible pit. You are bringing me out of nakedness. You are bringing me out of wretchedness. You are bringing me out of sickness. You are bringing me out of infirmity. You are bringing me out of disease and lack and shortage in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and just appreciate him, because the God of heaven is set to doing great things this hour. Thank you, our Father. We give you glory. We give you honor. Thank you, Father, for this second half of the year. Thank you for what you did from January till June. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your mercy that preserved us. Thank you for your mercy that kept us. Thank you for every family that is watching this telecast right now. Thank you for their lives. Thank you for their situations. Thank you for their families, their loved ones, near and far, home and abroad, wherever they are. Thank you for your hand that has been good upon them from the beginning of the year till the end of the first half of the year. And here we are today by your mercies, oh God, in the second half of 2020. To you alone be all the glory. To you alone be all the honor. Thank you for this month of July, our month of I will arise. Thank you for what you have said to do already. We give you glory and praise, oh God. Thank you, mighty Father. Blessed be your holy name, oh God. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. I want to thank God for you this morning. And quickly, I want you to please join me. We want to read the book of Micah chapter 7 verse 8. This month has been declared our month of I will arise. And the text is taken from Micah chapter 7 and verse 8. And we'll be praying there shortly before the word of the Lord is brought to us. Micah chapter 7 verse 8. He said, rejoice not against me, O my enemy. He said, when I fall, I will arise. And when I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be a light unto me. I want you to lift up your voice wherever you are this morning. I don't know where you are right now, but you are rising in the name of Jesus. I don't know what has kept you down, what has tied you down, what has made you to bow your head and buried your confidence. But this month, beginning from this morning of this dominion service, your head shall be lifted up. Lift up your voice with me this morning, wherever you are. Somebody is waiting to see your fall so that they can rejoice over you, but they will be disappointed. Oh, I said they will wait in vain. Wherever you are watching us from this morning, lift up your voice, because God has already concluded his program and his plan to raise your head this month. Say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, lift me up, oh God. Lift up my head. Lift up my family. Lift me from shame to glory. Go ahead and talk to him this morning. It is our month of I will arise. And it begins with a personal decision, a personal declaration. Speak it in the hearing of the one that is able to lift you. And say, Father, lift me up this month, oh God. Bring me out of the merry clay. Bring me out of that shame. Bring me out of that lack. Bring me out of this embarrassment. Bring me out of this sickness. Bring me out of this infirmity. Every curse, oh God, that has held my destiny down. Lord, today, by the power in the blood, let them be broken. I will arise out of shame into glory. I will arise out of failure into success. I will arise out of defeat into victory. Lift up your voice. Tell the Lord this morning. His hand is already stretched forth and is bringing you to your next level. Thank you, mighty Father. Blessed be your holy name, oh God. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. When you read the book of Acts chapter 13 and verse 22, the first part of that place, the Bible says that when he had removed him, he raised up David. When he had removed him, talking about King Saul, Bible says God removed King Saul and he raised up King David. God that did that for David will do it for you this month. Whatever must be removed so that you can be raised will be removed. Whoever must be removed so that you can rise will be removed. This is what you're going to say this morning. I say, Father, everything that will not allow me to rise, everything that is resisting my rising, this morning, Father, remove it, oh God. Every limitation, every embargo, every pronouncement of the enemy, every enchantment, every sorcery, every divination, whatever the enemy has put together to resist my rising in this month of July, in the second half of this year, Father, remove it, oh God. Remove it, oh God. What whatever must be removed, so that the head of your people may be lifted up, so that their businesses, their finances, their joy, their peace may be lifted up. Lord, I ask this morning, let it be removed, O God. The same hand that removed Saul was the same hand that raised David. Lord, I ask, O God, whatever the enemy has put together to keep this your children down, in this month of July, Father, I ask, O God, that you will remove it. In this dominion service, remove that sickness, remove that limitation, remove that nakedness, remove that reproach, remove that failure, remove that embargo, remove that siege, O God. Let your people rise. Let them rise like an edifice. Let them make progress. Let them step into their testimony. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. And finally, you are going to pray with me, because it takes light to rise. It takes light to rise. And when we talk about light, we are talking about insight. We are talking about revelation. Isaiah chapter 60 verse 1, he said, arise and shine. He said, for your light as what has come. It takes light. When light comes, you must rise. When light comes, nothing can stop your rising anymore. Lift up your voice with me wherever you are. And the light of God is coming as the word of God is coming after now. As God's word is being sent to you, it will alight upon you. It will lighten your destiny. And this is the prayer you're going to pray lastly this morning. I say, Father, send light to me for me to arise. The light for me to use to rise this month. Father, send it to me via your word in the mighty name of Jesus. That insight I need, that revelation I need, Lord, that illumination I need, that direction I need, that instruction I need, that correction I need, that adjustment that I need, Lord, by your word, oh God, this morning, Lord, send it to me. The Bible says he sent a word unto Jacob and it had lighted upon Israel. Lord, as your word will be coming this morning, every one of your children connected to this service, oh God, let that word light upon them. Let that word lighten them. Let that word instruct them. Let that word direct them. Let that word inspire them. Let that word, oh God, inform them. Let that word, oh God, correct them. In the mighty name of Jesus, whatever they must know, whatever they must be aware of, whatever they must be awake to, Father, by your word this morning, send your word. Your word is light, oh God. Let there be light in everyone's spirit. Let there be light in everyone's heart today. In the name of Jesus, by your word, oh God, let everyone's rising be confirmed by the power of your light. Thank you, mighty Father. I give you glory. I give you praise. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. I want to thank God for you this morning. God's word is about to come to you. I want your spirit to be open. I want you to be ready. Your light is coming. And once your light arrives, your rising is confirmed. You become unstoppable after this month. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you glory and praise for this month you have declared for us that it's our month of rising. Lord, nothing will stop us from rising. And we will get to the place you have prepared for us. We thank you for the vessel that you have prepared. Lord, let your power envelope her. In the name of Jesus, let her speak like an oracle. Let her be used mightily today. Let the door of utterance be opened unto her. And let your name alone be glorified. Thank you, our Father. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
It's offering time. Quickly, let's open our Bible to Psalm 20. I'll be taking some few verses there so that we can anchor our offering on that scripture. The Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. Send thee help from the sanctuary and strengthen thee out of Zion. Remember all thy offerings and accept thy burnt sacrifice. Grant thee according to thy own heart and fulfill all thy counsel. What I want you to do this morning is to prepare an offering that God will remember. An offering that God will remember. I want to tell you some few things. Every offering opportunity is opportunity to escape from suffering. Number two, every sowing opportunity is an opportunity to escape from sorrowing or borrowing. And every offering opportunity is opportunity to have access to the treasury of heaven for blessing. And this is why you have to prepare a good offering this morning. And this morning we are going to offer three offerings. We are going to offer clap offering. We are going to offer dance offering. And we are going to offer dance offering. Praise the Lord. Even if we don't have the third one, you will have the first two. And so this morning, I want you to prepare your offering, bountiful offering, and cheerfully, you know, go before the Lord as we drop our offering. Clap offering, dance offering, and cash offering. Please, choir, please.
Come and join me, sing hallelujah. Jehovah Jireh has done me well.
In heaven, we thank you because all that we have, you gave to us. The breath of life that is in us, even at this moment, Father, you gave it to us. And for this, Lord, we are grateful unto you. Please, Lord, accept our thanks in the mighty name of Jesus. We have brought our offering before you this morning. Please, Lord, accept us and accept our offering in the name of Jesus. Your children, they have dropped their offering. I ask that, Lord Almighty, you will close every door of suffering in the mighty name of Jesus. The hands that have dropped into the basket this morning, they will never go down financially. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Please sanctify the offering. Cause it to be used for the expansion of your work here on earth. Thank you, Eternal Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
So if God has done something in your life, from all the dominion services we've been doing for since we began, or from the last one, or God just did something in your life, even before you got here, can we see your hands up wherever you are? God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Please come forward. We'll take your testimony. I'm also one of them. Hallelujah. Every time you share testimony, testimony begets more testimony. Please keep coming. Keep coming.
I want to bless the name of the Lord. This is my left leg. I came to the church and give testimony that it has been paining me for long and they wanted to do the operation and the Lord healed me. So like a month after or 2 months, this second leg started. I was like, devil, you are a liar. I've already testified and God will heal me. So this leg, I didn't even notice again. I was here this morning ministering and joining the choir to sing in the first prayer meeting. So I knelt down there And it come to me that this leg is not paining me because I can't use it at all. I was now hitting it like this, doing it like this, as if this, nothing is happening. When I was there too, I was doing it that God, I want to come and testify. I want to confirm very well that this leg has gone. To God be the glory.
Hallelujah.
It has left me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Last year, by this time, I was in the hospital. I was carrying a big wound on my leg. And it was something else. I thank God for his faithfulness. I thank God for Dr. and Prof. Mrs. for their divine intervention over the injury. In fact, sometime when I was in the hospital, I would just be looking at the leg. I would say, God, can I be able to move again? But I just thank God for their divine intervention. I thank God. God used them. But Dr. Onokoya came when he said after that week, the following week, maybe the leg would have been something else. They would have amputated the leg. But I just thank God for God used them mightily to bring back my leg. I thank God for my children, for my mother, for adding another year to my age. I'm so happy. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I thank God for the salvation of my soul. I want to thank God Almighty for being a faithful God. Last month when we came to remember me, oh Lord, I came not very happy because my husband was not happy. There was a proposal that they be. In fact, he was the lead person. He was the one that they gave the grace to call some other people who he think can do the work. But when the list came out, his name was not there. The people that he called started calling him. We've seen our name, but his name, he wasn't happy. But I told him that he should not worry. So when we came for the last month Dominion service, remember me, O Lord, that was my major prayer point. And by the time I got home on that Saturday, he told me someone called him from the office that his name is on the list. But because he was still doubting, on the following Monday, he traveled to Abuja, and his name was there. I just want to give glory to God Almighty, the God that answered prayer. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I thank God this morning for the opportunity to testify to the power of God. I thank God that God is the Father for the fatherless, for the widow, and for everyone. I thank God that God helped me in every way. Last week that we went for the special Holy Ghost conference, I just went there with little money. Getting there, I just saw some people, they said, take. Then there is one ride they gave us when we went to police and to meet our daddy Dio. I normally kept those things. I thank God that since that ride was with us, God is adding more to it. I bless his holy name.
Hallelujah. All the my steps in your word, dear Lord, lead me, guide me every day. Send your anointing, Father, I pray. All the my steps in your word, please, all the my steps in your word.
All the my steps
in your word,
in your word, dear Lord.
Lead me, guide me,
every day.
sanctified. Let the words of my mouth be acceptable in thy sight. Take charge of my tongue all day and night. All the my saints in your word. Peace out of my state in your word.
I want to walk worthy according to your will, Lord.
According to your will.
Please hold my steps.
Please hold my steps.
Yeah. Now do your pleasure with me. The world is never changing.
Hallelujah. Shall we please go ahead and give him glory? Let's give him honor. Let's give him adoration. It's worthy to be praised. It's worthy to be lifted. It's worthy to be adored. is worthy to be glorified, is worthy to be magnified, is the King of all kings, is the Lord of all lords, is the Ancient of Days. Let us thank God for bringing us into second half of the year 2020, not by power nor by might, only by the grace of God alone, by the mercy of God alone, that we are still alive. Despite the pandemic, we are still alive. Let's give him glory, honor, adoration. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed.
You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Heavenly Father, we declare that you are the Almighty. You are the King of all kings. You are the Lord of all lords. You are the Ancient of Days. You are the Rose of Sharon. We want to thank you for what you have done so far. Thank you for the past dominion services. Thank you for what you have done already. Thank you for the testimonies. Take all the glory, honor, adoration in Jesus' name. Father, we have come this morning again. Please have your way in the name of Jesus. However you will do it, that every one of us today will arise in the name of Jesus. Just go ahead and do it in Jesus' name. That spiritually we will arise, physically we will arise, financially we will arise, in every area we will arise, and everybody will celebrate in their different homes. Thank you, Father, for hearing. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Let somebody shout hallelujah. I won't say you should give yourself high five, but you can smile with one another and say, thank God we're already in July. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We want to thank God for the opportunity again to minister to us. I want to thank God for the life of our daddy, Pastor Adeyokunu, for giving us the opportunity to minister again. The Lord bless you, sir, in Jesus' mighty name. By the grace of God, our theme for the month says, I will arise. Can somebody say, I will arise?
I will arise.
And you will arise in the name of Jesus. Amen. I will arise in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The word arise means to begin to occur. To begin to occur or to exist. To begin to occur or to exist. Or to begin at a source, beginning from somewhere. Or you can say to get up from sleeping. Maybe you are sleeping and the Lord is saying, arise. Meaning what? Stand up from that sleep. Somebody will get up from sleep, spiritual sleeping in the mighty name of Jesus. Or to call me to being or to attention. And I love that. To call me to being or to attention. That is another meaning for arise. Meaning what? Many people are just walking all around. They are nobody. Like, they are just walking like a walking corpse. The Lord will take you higher in Jesus' mighty name. Some are spiritually down. Some are physically down. In any area that you are down today, God will lift you up in Jesus' mighty name. Maybe financially, materially, or maritally, maybe you're on the same spot. The Lord will take you higher in Jesus' mighty name. You will arise, and I will arise in the mighty name of Jesus. Our text for the theme is in Micah chapter 7, verse 8. Micah 7, 8. Like our pastor that did the opening prayer said,
Micah 7 verse 8. But for this sermon, I'm going to start from verse 5 so that we can have the understanding of that word. Micah 7, 5 to 8. The Bible says, trust ye not in a friend. And I want you to mark that. Trust ye not in a friend. Put ye not confidence in a guide. Keep the doors of thy mouth from her that lieth in thy bosom. For the son dishonoreth the father. Can you imagine that? The daughter riseth up against her mother. The daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. A man's enemies are the men of his own house. Therefore, and I want to mark that, therefore, I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. Verse 8 now says, rejoice not against me, O my enemy. When I fall, I shall do what? I shall arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be a light unto me. Wow, that is loaded. That's why I read from that verse 5. The Bible says, don't trust in your friend. Any friend can disappoint you at any time. In fact, they don't mind taking your position. They don't mind collecting everything that you have labored for and killed you. But today, God will fight your battles and give you victory in the mighty name of Jesus. So trust not your friend. The Bible said, don't even trust your guide. And we have had so many guys killing their bosses all over Nigeria particularly. And sometimes, the Bible now says, even your spouse, don't trust them. Can you imagine that? Because there are husbands that are husbands. There are wives that are wives. There are husbands, Joseph, their wives for ritual. That will not be your lot in Jesus' mighty name. He said, you should be careful about your in-laws. Don't trust them. Because a man's enemies are the men of his own house. Then it now says in verse 7, he said, therefore, I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. Meaning what? I am not going to rely on my friend. I'm not going to rely on any brother or any sister. I'm not going to rely on any in-law. I'm not even going to rely on my spouse. But I will rely on God. When I cry to God, he will answer me. He said, therefore, I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. Many what? God is my maker. He brought me to the world for a purpose. And he is the only one that can help me. And I know if only I can pray, he will answer my prayer. And I know he will answer your prayer today in Jesus' mighty name. I say he will answer your prayer in Jesus' mighty name. And the Bible says in Isaiah 60 verse 1 and 2. The Bible says, arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. But the Lord shall rise upon thee, and his glory shall be risen upon thee. I think that Bible passage is meant for me, Sister Deyokono. And so shall it be for every one of us, in Jesus' name. The Bible says, you have been sitting there for so long. You have been on that same spot spiritually, physically, financially, materially, maritally. Arise. Stand up. Get up. Wake up. Stop where you are. You can move on. It can be better. And it's going to be better today in Jesus' mighty name. Meaning what? No matter the darkness. For instance, coronavirus all over the world is none of your headache. He said, you will arise. Coronavirus is not your Lord. Darkness can cover the whole world. It's not meant for you. You are a child of light. In the mighty name of Jesus. However, there's a saying, spiritual controls the physical. If it is not well spiritually, it might not be well physically. That is why you need to work upon your spiritual life so that you can really arise and shine and rule your world. In Jesus' mighty name. So spiritual sleeping is different from physical sleeping. It's quite different. But the Lord will wake up as many giants that are sleeping, especially now that many people are really confused. Even people that say, I am a child of God, they are confused. There is fear everywhere. God will deliver somebody today from that spirit of fear in the mighty name of Jesus. So, number one, if you are spiritually down, if you are spiritually on the same spot, especially now, if you pray, He will hear. If you pray, He will answer you. If you can open up unto your Maker, like Micah said, I will only look unto the Lord. I'm not going to see my husband, my wife, my children, my family member, even my friend. My friend will have nothing to offer. But I will look unto the Lord. So you too, if you are spiritually down, pray, God will answer you. Maybe your prayer life is zero. Maybe your fasting life is gone. You find it difficult to pray. You've been on fire before, but now you are no longer on fire. Maybe because of one reason or the other, maybe you've been disappointed. You're already discouraged. You're like, I can't pray again. I am tired. I cannot pray again. I can't go far again. Even fasting is no go area. Maybe your Bible study is also gone. And there's no how you can evangelize again. You have stopped everything because of that problem. Hello, you need help. And God will help you today in Jesus' mighty name. What am I trying to say? Please wake up. Wake up. And ask God to take you higher spiritually so that you can bounce back again. And I decree to somebody out there, you will bounce back. I say you will bounce back. Spiritually, you will bounce back. You will not be on that same spot. Maybe the devil has even padlocked your mouth. Today, I destroy that padlock that is not allowing you to pray fervently in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Ephesians 5:14. Ephesians chapter 5 verse 14 says, wherefore is yet awake thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light. Thank God our theme for the national level is let there be light. And God is saying, I will give you light. And He's going to give you light. And when there's light, you can see, you can become what God wants you to become. And so shall it be in Jesus' name. So if you are spiritually down, awake, stand up, stop allowing the devil to weigh you down. God will help you in Jesus' mighty name. And God will help me in Jesus' name. Isaiah 52:1 says, awake, awake. Put on thy strength, O Zion. Put on thy beautiful garment, O Jerusalem, the holy city. For henceforth there shall no more come into thee the uncircumcised and the unclean. Awake, put on your strength. Remember how you started. Remember how you were firing on. Remember how you were walking with God. Remember how the Lord had been helping you. And come out, wake up. Think within yourself. Where am I coming from? Where I am now, and where am I going? Am I on the same spot spiritually? What about my prayer life, my fasting life, my Bible study? God is saying, arise. Arise, because the spiritual control the physical. If it is not well spiritually, it can't be well otherwise. So you need to stand up. You need to wake up spiritually. Come on, put on your strength again. Your garment of prayer. Your power of fasting. The Bible study should not be every Sunday. No. Take your Bible and study your Bible. The Bible says, this book of the law should not depart from your mouth. You will meditate there in day and night. Joshua 1:8. And Almighty God will take you higher. Spiritually, in Jesus' mighty name. Number two, if you are physically down, what do you do? Like Micah said, pray, look unto God. Pray unto God, He will hear your prayer and He will heal your disease. He will heal you. When I say you are physically dead, I'm talking about sicknesses or diseases all around the world, no matter the challenge that you are facing. Maybe your own is even coronavirus. Believe me honestly, God has cured coronavirus before. And God will heal you too because He's our healer. That's why His name is Jehovah Rapha, the Lord that healeth thee. And He's going to heal you today in Jesus' name. How am I so sure? The Bible says in 1 Peter 2:24, Jesus said, by my stripes ye were healed. By stripes you have been healed more than 2,000 years ago. He has taken 40 strokes of cane because of that disease, because of that sickness. And today, just claim your healing. Cry to God and say, oh God, heal me. And you are getting up from that sick bed in the mighty name of Jesus. I remember a sister that was sick. And they called me and they said, mommy, it's like this sister is not getting better. I said, let us go there. When we got there, she was lying on the floor. Nothing was really happening. So after the prayer, I said, sister, you need to stand up. Go and take your bath. That is faith. Walk. Walk now. Stand up now. And that was the end of sickness. The devil wants to always say, hey, I cannot stand up. There's no I can get up. The sickness is much. The pain is much. No, that is the work of the devil. That is the statement of the devil. Now, stand up. Arise and walk and receive your total health in Jesus' mighty name. Remember in 2 Kings chapter 20, 2 Kings 21 to 6, Ezekiah was sick to the point of death. And the Lord said, my servant, go and tell Ezekiah, he's not going to survive from that sickness. I'm going to take him home. Just tell him to prepare his home because he's coming back home. When the man of God left, Ezekiah faced the wall and said, oh God, remember. Remember how I loved you. Remember how I served you. And before the man of God could leave the gate, God said, turn back. I have seen the tears of Ezekiah. Go and tell him, I am adding 15 more years. Ezekiah lived another 15 years. You will also live. As long as God wants. In Jesus' mighty name. Number three. If you are financially laid down, lift up your eyes unto him. From that our Bible test, lift up your eyes unto him and pray. He will lift you up. Maybe you are always from hand to mouth. Our thing this month says, I will arise. Enough is enough. And with your mouth, you are going to confess something positive. If you don't reject it, then we say, ah, poverty will say, I love you. I am finding it easy in your life. Oh. In fact, this garment of poverty that I put upon you, I don't want to remove it because I am enjoying the way you are even managing me. Can you imagine that? And there are believers out there. They are like, the first statement, how are you doing? There is nothing, nothing. How can a child of God be saying there is nothing, nothing? Say to somebody, I have more than enough. It's whatever you say that will come to pass. You will arise from that spirit of poverty in the mighty name of Jesus. Remember the arm of flesh will fail you. The widow of the son of prophet cried unto Elisha and said, nothing at all, but I have a pot of oil. Just a little oil. The man of God said, go and sell it. 2 Kings chapter 4. You can read from verse 1 to 7. And that was the end of poverty. The woman became oil dealer in a moment. Who says God cannot repeat the same thing? Who says he cannot supply all your needs? Come on, arise and shine and prosper. And you will arise. You will prosper. In the mighty name of Jesus. People that are looked down on you, they will begin to look up to you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because in my little journey in this world, I discover even people that are dashing you money, it's not because they love you. Sometimes they are tired of you. They don't want to see you. When you are coming, they tell their children, tell that sister that I am not around you because she's coming to ask for money. And you know, some people in the church today, they are like, what would I call them? Holy beggar. They will dress very well, but the way they will package themselves, I am not talking about those. They are like 419. They come to collect. So if you are one of them, you better change so that God can take you higher too. And God will take you higher in Jesus' name. But if you are doing that tomorrow, you are not lazy. You are working and there's nothing to show forth. God will take you up. God will lift you higher in Jesus' mighty name. That's why the Bible says in 3 John verse 2, 3 John verse 2, it says, beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. Many what? God wants us to prosper in every area. So why must you say nothing, nothing? Some people say, as you see me, there is nothing. That is not your statement in Jesus' name. God will take us higher financially. They will take away poverty. And every garment of poverty upon you, I consume by the fire of God in Jesus' mighty name. 2 Corinthians 8:9 says, Jesus Christ, because of you, became poor, so that through his poverty you might be rich. So if he has become poor because of me, then nothing should stop me from being rich. Say to somebody by your side, I am a millionaire. I am not a poor person. I am not a poor person. The problem with some children of God is they always confess it that I don't have money. I don't have money. Where will you have money? All of us have done it before. God deliver us. God will deliver you. So I don't want to hear that language of I don't have. Even when you don't have, tell God, I am rich. That's what they taught us in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. I am rich. In fact, I am full now. I have more than enough now, even though there's nothing. And that thing that you are claiming will really come to you. But when you say there's nothing, Satan will say, amen. Oh, Leni, you can't have it because you don't want it. You are not confessing it. But that will change today in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree to somebody out there, arise and prosper in Jesus' mighty name. Number 4, if you are down maritally, what do you do again? You pray, you look unto him from that Micah that we have read. Pray, and God will intervene. Because it says in Genesis 1:28, he said, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth. Beloved, I declare, you are coming out from that barrenness. In the mighty name of Jesus, no matter how many years you have been in that position, God will take you higher. And in fact, that journey begins now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Your father, our daddy Gio, said it many times during this lockdown, that this lockdown, pastors should be getting ready for naming ceremonies. He didn't say naming ceremonies, ceremonies. Because lockdown is just for you. So that all the up and down, running up and down, that has not allowed any homo to settle. Everything you will settle, you cool down, you calm down, your husband will cool down and calm down, cooler, you become pregnant. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So, barrenness is not for you. You will arise maritally. In the name of Jesus. So, arise from barrenness. And no matter what, delay is not denial. No matter how long you have stayed in that barrenness, you are coming out today. Enough is enough. You are a child of authority. So, arise. Go and get your baby things ready. Go to the market. Buy everything that you need to buy for your babies. As if the babies are around. Carry them, invisible babies, and begin to rejoice. I am getting up. I am standing up. I am no longer barren. Then the Lord will say, I can see my daughter dancing. I can see my son dancing. And suddenly, you see a new thing will begin to develop in the womb. And receive it now. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Beloved, when you think God is coming late, it's coming big. It's actually coming big. So maybe you have been praying, oh God, just one child. Otito, only one, I'm okay. Just let me have a child. And God will surprise you with 4 at a time. Because it's the Almighty God, for with him all things are possible. So you will arise and get out of barrenness in Jesus' mighty name. He did it for Sarah. He did it for Elizabeth. He did it for Rachel. You are number next in Jesus' mighty name. Number 5. Are you officially on the same spot? Pray. Maybe your boss does not even want to see your face. Pray and you will arise. Psalm 75 verse 6 says, for promotion cometh neither from the east nor from the west, nor from the south. Verse 7, but God is the judge. He putteth down one and setteth up another. Like the pastor that prayed, led us. Whatever God will do that you are going to receive your promotion, God is ready to do it. The only thing is, pray. Don't look unto man. Like that, I want you to study that mic on your own. He said that I'm not going to trust any of them. I will look unto God. So even though the enemy will say, hey, we are finished, sir. We are finishing. No, he will lift me up again. I will arise. That's that prophet for you. And God will take you higher. He will promote you. If there's anybody standing upon your promotion, I declare that God Almighty will set fire on their buttock in Jesus' name. Wherever they are, God will set fire on their buttock in the name of Jesus. And you are going to be promoted by fire, by force. They won't even know. In the mighty name of Jesus. In fact, some of you will receive double promotion. In Jesus' mighty name. Somebody say in this lockdown, God is able. Even in this lockdown, you get your promotion. Just believe in it because it is settled. In Jesus' mighty name. God inside will promote you and nobody will be able to pull you down again. And you'll be moving from one level to another Until people begin to ask you, how are you doing it? Are you the only one in this office? Last year you were promoted. Promotion is not by years. So I'm telling you the truth. It's not by years. It's not because, you have spent 5 years, 7 years on the same spot. That's why you can be promoted every year. If you please the Lord, if you can pray to him, if you can please the Lord, you can be promoted every year. They will just say, that boy has impressed me. That man has impressed me. That woman has impressed me. Promote her again. Promote her favor. I decree and declare divine favor upon you in Jesus' mighty name. And are you down academically? Number 6, are you academically down? Pray. He will turn the tide. He's the almighty God. He can turn the tide at any time. It will turn the tide and you will soon be the best. The best out of the best in Jesus' mighty name. How am I so sure? The Bible says in Psalm 119 verse 99, God said, you will know more than your teachers. Can you imagine that? When you know more than your teacher, by the time they read the first paragraph, they say, this one knows where he's going. He has already passed. You know what? Some of you, it's not because you're a failure. But the first impression you have given them, the first statement, the moment they read the first answer like this, they will say, what else can he write? What else can she write? No, I don't want to waste my time. I don't want to 10%. But your story will change today in the mighty name of Jesus because you will be the best among the best and you are coming out of failure in the mighty name of Jesus. Number 7, are you facing the shadow of death? Are you facing the shadow of death? Arise and pray. It will lift you up. It will lift you up. That sickness you are facing is not unto death. That sickness will not kill you. Our God is not a killer. Our daddy has told us severally, he's not a killer. When Elijah was tired and he was running from Jezebel, oh God, I am jealous of you. I have done this and that. And look at, they are seeking for my soul to destroy. God said, wake up, stand up, heat, because the journey is far. So I decree and declare, you are standing up too in Jesus' name. So that sickness is not unto death. Stop saying, I don't know how to survive this. You are going to survive. You will survive it. With God on your side, you will survive. That is why Psalm 23 verse 4, Psalm 23:4 says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. I walk through the valley. It's like shadow of death. I don't know what is happening. Everywhere is like dark, but you are coming out brighter. You are coming out brighter, man. It's not going to kill you. You are not going to die before your time. In the mighty name of Jesus. When the devil is coming to harass you, whether physically or spiritually, come on, say capital no to the devil. The Bible says, I shall not die but live. To declare the words of the Lord. Are you ready to declare the words of the Lord? Are you ready to be an evangelist? Then you will arise and you will roll your word. And death will see you and run. In the mighty name of Jesus. All you need is faith. All you need is faith. Whether you are in sorrow, it can turn your sorrow to joy. It can turn even your loneliness around. Are you a single person trusting in God for husband or wife? God is ready to give you one. Don't let this lockdown. He will open your eyes and see. And you will see Mr. Right. You will see Miss Right. In the mighty name of Jesus. All you need this morning is your faith. Can God lift me up spiritually, physically, financially, materially, maritally, academically, ministerially, emotionally, is lifting you up. enough is enough for being on the same spot. You are standing up. What am I trying to tell you this morning? Open your eyes. Just say, oh God, enlighten my eyes. Like the psalmist pray. Lest I say the sleep of death. I want to see. Open your eyes and see Jesus. If the Lord can open your eyes to see where you ought to be, then you know that you need to arise. You need to stand up. If the Lord will open your eyes to see, even some of us that are worthy now, we think that we are worthy. If the Lord will open your eyes to see where you ought to be, you will weep and say, oh God, I have not even achieved so much at all. I have not even started. See what you are prepared for me. See where I am. Almighty God will open your eyes. So you just need to say, open your eyes and see Jesus. Open your eyes and see salvation from Jesus Christ. Open your eyes and see your healing now. Open your eyes and see deliverance now. Open your eyes and see fruitfulness. Stop seeing barrenness. Stop seeing sickness. Open your eyes and see promotion. Open your eyes and see prosperity. Open your eyes and see success coming your way. Open your eyes and see life and not death. Somebody cried to one of my fathers in the Lord some years ago and said, Daddy, 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 pray for me. Pray for me. He said, what is wrong with you? He said, I had a dream. I saw some people bury me. They dug a pit and they put me inside him. And by the time he now woke up from that dream, the pastor said, they put you in the pit. They wanted to bury you. And you are the one reporting the case to me. You have won the battle. You have won the battle. And that was the end. That settles it. Believe me honestly, Almighty God that we serve is still on the throne. He's alive forever. And we continue to fight your battles and give you victory in Jesus' name. So open your eyes and see life. You know why I'm saying this? There is fear all over the world now because of COVID-19. Everybody is afraid. Oh, I don't know. I don't know what is happening. I don't know whether. Even when they cough now, it's a problem. They are like, hey, I hope it's not coronavirus cough. When they sneeze now, it's a problem. I hope it's not coronavirus. It's like I went out yesterday and so what? Open your eyes. Don't allow the devil. That sometimes the devil can harass you in the dreamland. Enough is enough. Come on. Say to somebody, Danu. Any dream that is not originating from God, what do? Danu, discard it. Delete it. Reject it. By the time you stand up from that revelation, oh God, I reject, it's not my portion. In the name of Jesus, poverty, you are not my portion. I can see you coming, yo, it's a lie. The Bible says, I wish above all things that I prosper in everything. So as you say to his hearing, so he will do unto you. Not that after that nightmare, you say, hey, and I saw myself, oh, I went back to square one. Come on, that is the plan of the devil. Don't celebrate it. Don't think about it. Don't embrace it. You embrace it when you are not saying, I've seen it coming. That's why I disagree with some people that say, hey, we have seen it. When you are saying, God wants you to pray. That's what our daddy taught us. He will say, oh, let us pray. Let us fast concern this and that. He wouldn't want it to happen. That's a genuine man of God. As a child of God, do the same thing. You see there, you reject it. What do? Danu. I say, it's not my portion. Then God will say, yes, this is my son. This is my daughter. I am lifting you up. And he will take over the battle from there. And he will give you victory. So what do you see this morning? Are you seeing Jesus Christ? Are you seeing life? Are you seeing prosperity? Are you seeing fruitfulness? As a student, are you seeing success? Stop seeing failure as a student. You are not a failure. He didn't create you to fail in life. If he has created you to fail, you wouldn't even come into this world at all. You know, everybody that came into the world is for a purpose. Your way fulfilled destiny. In the mighty name of Jesus. The enemy will not be able to truncate your destiny. In the mighty name of Jesus. So no matter the level you are, arise. Wake up. And it's by your mouth that you will say it. I will arise from poverty, from sorrow, from barrenness, from failure. From anything negative, I will arise and I will shine. I will roll my word. With this, my little faith, that I believe in the word of God, I will roll my word in Jesus' name. So you need to just celebrate your rising. Celebrate your rising because you are coming out. Whether the devil wants it or not, no matter how many there are, no matter how many, no matter what, celebrate your rising and take a step from today. I have heard the word of God. I need to take a step of faith. That is work plus faith. I will arise and be promoted. What towards it? So what do I do now to keep on rising? You want to keep on rising after today? You want to keep on rising? Number one, you must be genuinely connected with Jesus Christ. Matthew 11, 28 say, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. Be genuinely connected to Jesus. Number two, you must love righteousness. Number three, you must be renewed. According to Romans 12, 1 and 2, you must be transformed and be renewed. Then you must be rooted in the word of God. Joshua 1, 8. Study the Bible. The will of God is in the word of God. There's no way you study the Bible that God will not minister to you. Whether you need something spiritual, physical, financial, material, marital, everything is in the word of God. There's a passage for you in the Bible. Just pick your Bible and read. And you know, you will arise in Jesus' mighty name. Then give yourself to prayer. I said a lot on that. Matthew 7, 7. Whatever you ask, he will give you. If you seek, you will find. If you knock, the door will be open. It's only when you close your mouth. That's why there's a saying again. A closed mouth is a closed what? Destiny. You will not close your destiny by closing your mouth in Jesus' mighty name. Then also pray for divine guidance. You want to keep on rising? You must not mess up. Pray that God will guide you in all your ways. In fact, when God guides you beginning from today, many of you are doing wrong job, wrong assignment. You are not where God wants you to be because you just want to put on suit and this. And God has said, go and start a business. Today, God will open your eyes again. In Jesus' mighty name, then pray for divine helpers like Naaman's house girl. Happen to be a divine helper to Naaman. Also, you too can pray for divine helpers who can lift you up in every area. Somebody who is ready to lift you up, not those people that are not ready. They are on top there, but they don't want anybody to meet them there. Talk less of passing them. But somebody who is ready to lift you up, God will direct that person to you in Jesus' mighty name. Then, having done that, pray against all hindrances to your rising. The enemy don't want you to rise, oh. That is the truth. But pray against such enemy that say no to your rising, that God will clear them away as you are rising. That's why I say, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. They will only what? They will not be able to attack me. That's why Jabez prayed the same prayer. Deliver me from enemy. Enlarge my cause, oh, but remember that enemies. Don't let them overcome me. Jabez prayed that prayer. So you too, pray against all hindrances to your lifting. Then be diligent in whatever you do. Be diligent in whatever you do according to Proverbs 22, 29. Obey the word of God, Deuteronomy 28, 1 and 2. Then acting diligently unto God. Listen to God. Let him open your eyes so that you can see. Then, whether you believe it or not, you want to keep on rising, pay your tithe. Pay your offering, and God will give you the grace. Forget all those people that are talking rubbish about tithe and offering. They have nowhere to go. You pay. It's the only one to hinder you. They want to hinder your prosperity and your blessing and your rising. Don't allow them. So pay your tithe and pay your offering. Also pay your first fruit. Pay your first fruit. Proverbs 3:1. Concerning tithe, Malachi 3:10. Then you must give your offering. Luke 6:38. Then finally, give sacrificially, especially during this coronavirus. Don't say this money that I'll be keeping. I don't know where the coronavirus will go. Offering. I'm not paying offering. Tithe, no tithe. I don't know where coronavirus will leave us in Nigeria. So let me keep my money. This is the time you're supposed to sacrifice. Sacrificial offering. Then God will say, eh? You know, ISIS sold in the land. And in that same year, the Bible says he reaped hundredfold. You too sow in the period of famine. That's when Isaac sow. This is the period of famine in Nigeria. You too sow that little one in your hand. Then God will say, I am coming big in your life. And it will come big in Jesus' name. However, this morning, I implore you, if you are not genuinely born again, you need to surrender your life to Jesus Christ. Otherwise, there's no rising for you. That is not a cause. It's just the simple truth. You want to keep on rising? You need to surrender your life to Jesus Christ. And if you're a backslider, you need to return back home, because In the world, you can see now, the world has nothing good to offer you. In the world, sickness, sorrow, pain, poverty, failure, stagnation, mention it. Everything is in the world. In fact, the world will lure you into sin of adultery, fornication. Then, at the end of the day, they will snatch your wife or your husband. Not only that, when they see that you are prospering, they can kill and take over your business. It's happening all over the world. So this morning, you need to make a U-turn and say, like that prodigal son, I am coming back home. I've wasted so many years. Nothing in the world. According to Luke chapter 15, verse 18, the prodigal son says, I will arise and go to my father. Luke 15, 18, I will arise and go to my father and we say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee. The father embracing, God is ready to embrace you. No matter how far you have gone deep, no matter the sin, if you lie, maybe you have gone with concubine for many years, turn back. Forget that shame. The devil wants you to feel ashamed. Forget the shame. You just make a U-turn. You see, what have you lost when you have left your wife or your husband? What have you lost? You have lost so many things. You didn't gain so much. What have you really gained with that concubine? With that adulterer? What have you gained? Nothing. They will take away your money, finish your life, and after which they go. I've seen a lot on that. No more time for testimony. I will have given you one. After finishing the money, the woman will say, you don't have anything to offer again. I am going back. And they go and look for another sugar daddy. That's a miserable life. You now turn to square one. Come on, wake up. Go back to your wife. Restitute your way, and God will accept you back in Jesus' mighty name. Jesus says, I stand, behold. Revelation 3:20. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him. I will sup with him and eat with me. Jesus is ready to save you. He said, whosoever. Whosoever. If any man hear my voice, any woman, adulterer, fornicator, liar, we hear my voice. Are you hearing the voice of Jesus this morning? And you are not yet born again? Why not bow down your hands and say, oh Lord, have mercy upon me. Forgive me all my sins. And write my name in the book of life. In the name of Jesus. Pray that prayer quickly. If you want to surrender your life to Jesus, very soon you are going to see our contact on the screen. The phone number you are going to call so that they can be praying for you. And at the same time, if you surrender your life to Jesus Christ, our Daddy Gio will be praying for you as well. So feel free to contact us. And the Lord Almighty will save you to the end in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we thank you for the lives of all your children. Surrender their lives unto you right now. Please have mercy upon them. Forgive them all their sins. Write their names in the book of life. In your kingdom, let us see them there. Uphold them. All the bastards that are returning back home, please embrace them. Give them the grace never to go back into their vomit. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Now, anywhere you are, all over, please, shall we please be on our feet? Let's please rise up so that we can pray together. Let's pray some prayers now. I want us to just begin to give in glory, honor, adoration for the opportunity to see the second half of the year. Giving glory, giving honor, giving adoration for the grace, the opportunity to see the second half of the year. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Beginning from this month of perfection, only you can do it. Let's thank God for mercy. Lamentation 3:22 says, of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed because his compassion fail not. Oh God, thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your mercy. From January up to this month of July, you have kept us safe and sound. Blessed be your name, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Are you praying where you are? I want you to cry now for mercy again. The Bible says, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his mercy endureth forever. Psalm 136, verse 1. Let's cry to God and say, Father, have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon Nigeria. Have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon my family. In wrath, remember mercy. In your anger, remember mercy. In judgment, remember mercy. Please have mercy on us. In any area that we have let you down, in any area that we have gone astray, have mercy in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I want you to now pray and say, Father, please help me to pray. Because I know when I cry to you, my maker, like Micah said, when I call upon the Lord, he will hear me. Oh God, give me the grace to pray, the power to pray in the name of Jesus. Because I know when I pray, you will hear and you will answer. Help me in the place of prayer. 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 I don't want to doze away in the place of prayer. I don't want to sleep away in the place of prayer. Wake me up in my prayer. Wake me up, oh Lord. Help me to pray. Help me to pray. Oh God, help me to pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The Bible says our God is a consuming fire. I want us to cry. Now I say cry, I may cry. Cry to God and say, Father, every chain, tie me down. Let your fire consume. Any chain of the devil, tie me down. Spiritually, physically, financially, materially, maritally. That is why you're on the same spot. Oh God, let your fire fall and consume them. Every chain, tie me down. Every chain that are not allowing me to move forward. Let your fire rose in the name of Jesus. Consume with your fire. Every chain of the devil, every chain of poverty, every chain of weariness in the place of prayer, let your fire consume. Every chain of barrenness, let your fire consume in the name of Jesus. That chain of sickness, oh yeah, let the fire of God consume now in the name of Jesus, that the name of the Lord will be glorified. Every chain, tie me down in any area of my life, let your fire consume in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. You will now pray again. Say, Father, I am ready for my lifting. I will arise. Spiritually, Lord, lift me up. Wake me up from spiritual slumbering. Wake me up in my prayer. Wake me up in my fasting. Wake me up in Bible study. The spiritual control the physical. Wake me up, oh Lord. Lift me up spiritually. I am tired of being on the same spot spiritually. Enough is enough. The devil has really been rejoicing over me. It is enough. Baba, wake me up. In the name of Jesus. Wake me up. Wake up my prayer life. Wake up my Bible study. In the name of Jesus. Wake up my fasting life. Wake up my evangelism. In the name of Jesus. I will arise spiritually so that I can be well with me in every other area. Wake me up spiritually, Lord. In any area that I'm sleeping, oh God, wake me up. Wake me up. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. You are set to your spiritual life now. Let's now pray and say, Father, lift me up from sick bed by your stripes. Make me whole. If I need spare part, supply. If I need surgical operation, do it now. All I need is a touch, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus, lift me up from any form of sick bed. No matter the sickness, no matter how the sickness got into my body, no matter when, no matter what, no matter what. Oh Lord, lift me up from sick bed. I am tired of sickness. I am tired of disease. I am tired, oh Lord. Measure that disease. Measure the name of that disease. I am coming out of failure. I am coming out from that sickness. From that high blood pressure, I am coming out. From hypertension, I am coming out. From diabetes, I am coming out. From kidney problem, liver problem, I am coming out. From heart failure, I am coming out. I am coming out from every form of sickness and disease. I try this. You are not my portion. I am coming out in the name of Jesus. Because by the stripes of Jesus, I have been made whole. I am coming out. I am coming out. God, you are my maker. If I need stepper, supply. If I need surgical operation, do it yourself. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. You now pray and say, Father, financially, lift me up. Put an end to poverty in my life. I am tired of heart to mouth. Lift up my hand, oh Lord. I am tired of begging. I am tired of moving from one place to the other before I eat, before I clothe myself. Oh God, lift me up financially. I am tired of wretched life. I am tired of poverty. I am tired, oh Lord. Lift me up while we arise. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Now pray and say, Father, lift me up maritally. Make me fruitful in every area I need you. Make me fruitful. If you are trusting in God for children, pray the prayer very well. Make me fruitful. In the name of Jesus, God said, none shall be barren in the land. Oh God, make me fruitful. I am ready for my fruitfulness. Make me fruitful, oh Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I want to pray the next prayer quickly and say, Father, help me to succeed in life. Put an end to failure in my life. In which area are you failing, brethren? Cry to God. I am tired of failure. There are people no success at all. They lay hands on this, they fail. They lay hands on that, they fail. I am tired of failure. Oh God, help me to succeed in life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Pray for your promotion now. I am tired of stagnation. Promote me, Lord. I am due for promotion. I am long overdue for promotion, oh Lord. Promote me. Promotion coming from you, my Father. Whatever you will do, if you need to put somebody down, put them down so that I can get to the throne. Promote me, Lord. However you will do it, Father, do it for me, Lord. Promote me, Lord. Spiritually promote me. Physically promote me. Financially take me higher. Promote me. Promote me, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The Bible says, I shall not die but live to declare the work of the Lord. We are going to cry to God and say, Father, speak life to me in every area of my life. In the name of Jesus, pray the prayer very well. Speak life to me, to every area of my life. Speak life unto every area of my life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I want you to now confess with your mouth and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I am coming out from sin. I am coming out from sickness. I am coming out from poverty. I am coming out from barrenness. I am coming out from failure. I am coming out from the shadow of death. I am coming out. I am coming out. I want you to move around wherever you are. Don't sit down now. Stand up and say, I am coming out. I am coming out of sickness. I am coming out of disease. I am coming out. I am coming out. I am coming out. I am coming out from poverty. I am coming out from barrenness. I am coming out from stagnation. I am coming out from failure. I am coming out from the shadow of death. I am coming out. I am coming out. God is taking me out. God is taking me out. Oh God, I am not on the same spot again. Rema shete kemo koribashanda. Rabababababababa. Rema shete kemo koribashanda. Karabaka hori amasanda. I am coming out. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I can see that you already have to run that problem. You are already rising. In the name of the Lord Jesus, and when that's your spirit lifted up now, I want you to cry to God and say, Father, everything that the devil has stolen from me, I recover her now. Oh, yep, stand up and recover her. You recover your health, recover your glory, recover your children. Everything that the enemy has stolen, I recover her. I recover her. I recover her. I recover her. In Jesus' name we pray. I want you to decree and declare total freedom for Nigeria. I say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I decree and I declare, Nigeria, arise, come out of every form of lockdown. Come out from coronavirus. Nigeria, oh yeah, come out. Come out, enough is enough. Come out, come out, come out, come out. Nigeria, come out. In the name of Jesus, come out from every form of lockdown. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Finally, I want you to pray now. I say, Father, I decree that all the children of God in any form of bondage, arise, arise. Any child of God in any bondage, no matter the name, oh yeah, arise, arise. Begin to command. Whether you know them, maybe they are your family members, arise. Anywhere form of bondage, the devil can tie somebody down. Look at that woman in Luke chapter 18. It was down. It was down for how many years? 18 years. In Luke 13. Oh God, lift up all your children. Arise, all your children of God. In any form of bondage, arise, 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 arise. Oh, yeah, stand up. All the children of God in isolation center. Oh, yeah, arise. All the children of God that are sick, arise. All the children that are of God that are in poverty, arise. All the children of God that are in failure, arise, arise. All the children of God that are in bondage, one bondage or the other, arise. Spiritually, arise. Physically, arise. Financially, arise. Maritally, oh yeah, arise. Arise, arise. This is your mouth arising. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. As we round up, we pray that the forthcoming annual convention will be glorious. Amen. It is that wonderful. And it's going to be wonderful. Amen. God will make everything beautiful. Amen. In the name of God the Father, Amen. God the Son, Amen. God the Holy Spirit, Amen. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Amen. Come and celebrate your rising now. Hallelujah. Celebrate your rising now. Hallelujah. Celebrate your rising now. Celebrate your rising. Celebrate your, come on, jubilate. Celebrate your rising. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Hallelujah. By the special grace of God, our beloved Mommy Gio will clock 72 on Monday. Let us say in one accord, every member of Lagos Province, Province 2. Say happy birthday, mommy. You will live long. God will prosper you. God will bless you. God will take you higher. In the name of Jesus. In the kingdom of God, we will all see you there. In Jesus' mighty name. God will take you for our daddy too. In the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Mommy, on behalf of all your children in Lagos Province 2, we say happy birthday. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Have a wonderful year in Jesus' mighty name. Beloved, go ahead and just celebrate your rising because you're unstoppable in Jesus' mighty name.
Oh, lead me up and let me stand. By faith on heaven's table land, where love and joy and light abound. Oh, plant my feet on higher ground. Oh, lead me up. Oh, lead me up. And let me stand by faith on heaven's table land, where love and joy and light abound. Oh, plant my feet on higher ground.
Stay in attitude of prayer. Let's just lift up our voices and bless the name of the Lord for the woman of God God has just used for us, for that wonderful ministration. Let's thank God for her life. And let's commit her to the hand of God that God will renew her strength. She'll be moving from strength to strength. Even as God has used her for our lifting today, she will be lifted in every area of life in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not diminish. God will lift you up. You will arise physically, spiritually, and maritally, and every area of your life where you need lifting in the name of Jesus. I want you to make a declaration. Our theme this month is a declaration that I will arise. I want you to speak with your mouth because the Bible says, as we say to his hearing, so will he do for us. I want you to declare to the hearing of God today and say, I will arise. I will arise from sickness to divine health. I will arise from poverty to prosperity. I will arise from sorrow to joy. Go ahead and make declarations. From failure to success, I will arise. I'm arising. I'm going up. I'm going higher. I will arise. I will arise from sickness. I'm going to divine health. I will arise from poverty. I'm moving on to prosperity. I will arise from failure. I'm moving on to success. This is my season of rising. This is my season of lifting. In the name of Jesus, I am arising. I am going higher. I'm moving forward. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. The Lord will lift you up.
Amen.
You will arise.
Amen.
From that sickness, you will arise.
Amen.
That sickness is not unto death. The Lord will lift you up.
Amen.
The Lord will pull you out.
Amen.
That person right now, you're seeing that you are in a state of dungeon. You are in a dungeon, in a miry clay. God will pull you up.
Amen.
You will arise.
Amen.
You will not die in that situation. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That sickness will not kill you. You will not die in that poverty. You will not die in that debt. In the name of Jesus, you will arise. You will arise to success. That student that failure has been your experience all the time, you will arise. To that graduating student, I say, you will arise. And you will graduate. In the name of Jesus. You will not repeat that class. In the name of Jesus. So shall it be. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Somebody shout hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord for the way the Lord has ministered to us again this month. And I think it is important that we show our appreciation to God by giving him our thanksgiving offering. Let's show to God that, God, we deeply appreciate you. We are not ingrates. You will see our bank account details right there on your screen. Let's do the needful. Let's give cheerfully. Let's give bountifully, because the Bible tells us that God loves cheerful givers. And those who sow bountifully, we also reap bountifully. I pray for you that you will not lack in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Poverty will not be your portion in the name of Jesus. The Lord will accept your offering in the name of Jesus. The Lord will reward you mightily in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Please give the Lord a just offering, not just
your
money. Hallelujah.
Oh, one life.
Before I close, I want you to make a demand of God. I want to make a special request, a personal request. And I want to join my faith with your faith as you make that request. In 1 minute, talk to God about what you want the Lord to do for you, especially in this month of July. And promise God that you will testify. I'm waiting for your testimony. Go ahead. I'm joining my faith with your faith right here, right now. Concerning that which is a burden in your heart, that which is your immediate heart desire, that you want the Lord to do for you quickly, that which you don't want to carry over to the month of August, that which you want to share the testimony this month of July. I pray in agreement with you concerning that burden. The Lord will lift your body. The Lord will answer your prayers. The Lord will minister to you in that particular situation that you cannot even discuss with any man. The Lord will arise for you in the name of Jesus. You will not die in that situation. I say to somebody that is listening to me right now, I say no shame for you. The enemy has planned shame for you this month, but that shame is canceled in the name of Jesus. Someone that is operating under ancestral curse, I decree in the name of Jesus, that curse is lifted in the name of Jesus, because you have been made a curse for us on the cross of Calvary. Therefore, no curse shall plague you again in the name of Jesus. I pray for everyone listening to me this moment. This month shall be your month of perfection. It shall be your month of lifting, a season of rising. I say no more falling for you. That person who have been falling steadily, that falling is, we put an end to it now. We put an end to it now. From that point now, begin to rise up. Begin to move on. Begin to press on. Very, 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 very soon, you are coming to share your testimony. This month of July is your month of testimony. I pray for all July children in Lagos province too. This month, the Almighty God will surprise you. God will give you a special birthday gift that no man can give. In the name of Jesus. Everyone listening to me, this is your month. This month, God will lift you up. God will give you a new testimony. It's a month of perfection. God will perfect everything concerning you. So shall it be. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Somebody shout hallelujah.